name's Callum. I studied material science and engineering.
Hey, my name's Sam, and I did my undergrad in aerospace engineering at the University of Bristol.
I'm Callum, and I am a chemist by training.
The DBT stands for Design Build Test. It's an opportunity for us to apply all the knowledge that we've learned from our CDT courses and to build an actual composite structure.
So there's five people in our team, spanning a couple of different backgrounds from engineering to chemistry.
This year we are designing, building and testing a composite landing gear beam for a commercial aircraft. We go through the process of design, so do the calculations to meet certain stress deflection requirements, so to get an accurate idea of material properties such as the stiffness of the carbon fiber we're planning on using to build our beam. We have laid up some laminates of the composite, cut them into coupons, and are testing them in experiments such as in-plane shear and bearing testing, for example.
So once we finished the design and got our data from materials testing, we could put them together into a computational model. And we could use this to give more detailed results of when we're going to fail and how much we're going to deflect.
And then go through the process of actually building the part out of composite, and then finally testing it to see if our final part, our design and our designed product meets the requirements that were set out for us.
At this moment we are manufacturing a composite beam. For doing that we need to have a mold wrapping from the outside, so we want to get a break from the things that are inside. In this case, the mold that we choose is a sand model, because it's very easy to dissolve.
Finally onto the layup, basically, and we were able to get it to meet on one of the faces, because we put down a metal sort of shim, and then lay up round, overlap it slightly and cut it, so that we can get a nice joint, so that not all of our joints are in one place on the beam. Because we've got paddock flies in our layup, we need to be able to accurately and repeatedly put them in the same place. So we've put these little cross marks onto the paddocks, and we've got, as you see behind me, the yellow piece of string, which will let us align it in the sort of longitudinal direction.
Today we're finally testing the beam. We've got two loads being applied to it. Vertically we've got about the weight of a reasonable sized van on it. Horizontally we're looking at a sort of small car weight. Then we've got loads of different ways we're taking in the data. So we've got a number of strain gauges which we can use to measure the strain from which we get the stress from. We're then using a high speed camera which films at 21,000 frames per second. And that's to try and find out how the beam actually breaks.
We've got two potentiometers in the middle and two at the end, allowing us to measure both the overall rotation and take away the rotation of the test frame itself. Now, we wanted a backup redundancy as well, so what we've also added is two video gauge systems either side. That way we can both measure the displacement by taking the average of the two video gauges and the rotation by taking the difference between them. Therefore, we have redundancies for rotation and displacement, which should allow us to produce a good result.
The FE model kind of indicates that it might fail by buckling either side of this padded up region here in the centre, but because of manufacturing defects that we kind of allowed for but happened, this could happen kind of anywhere on our beam. So it might happen in this region at the back here where we can't capture it on high speed camera.
High speed camera, video gauge 1 and 2. Okay, right. First of all, we're going up to a minus 4.93 transverse load. 4.7. You go. 4.8. Okay, we're going up to minus 8.8 on the transverse, right?
We might have
stopped
that.
Oh my god, we got it!
Enjoyed about the DBT was the chance to sort of really
get hands-on in the lab, see what you've designed, and then try and make that a reality.
I quite enjoyed that you have a whole process of the both the manufacturing and design, and you can understand how the product is really produced in the industry.
I think that was a huge bonus, was figuring out how to talk to real companies and getting some actual experience in the real world.
I had never done anything like that, layup or mechanical testing or pretty much everything that we did. This project actually helped me learn about structural engineering, and when it came to exams I already knew a lot of the stuff.
The challenges was splitting the work, because at the beginning we wanted to know everything and do everything, but it was not possible.
There's lots of other coursework and test examinations going on, so you need to have good control of the time.
I think I'd say to the next cohort, plan ahead and be ambitious.
Don't stick to one solution, because it's not gonna work with your first idea, so you have to try and try and try it until it looks okay.
You were exhausted by the end of it, but it was so worth it the next day when it all paid off.
It will be fun in the end, it will be worth it, and when you test the beam and it breaks, that's the best part.
It was the most fun for the year, wasn't it?